on August 19th, 2016, Greenville, South Carolina. One clown decided to take it upon himself to try to lure kids into the woods with large amounts of money and flashing laser lights. This terrified the residents of Greenville, South Carolina. And here's the story of how the clowns grew from there on.
Many days later, Greenville residents kept continuing to see clowns flashing green laser lights and trying to lure kids into the woods with their money. This frightened the Greenville residents.
The Sheriff County actually had sent a letter on 24th August 2016, warning them about the clown sightings and telling the residents to keep safe and setting a curfew for 10 o'clock. Since a lady had saw a clown at 2 o'clock in the morning, waving to her behind some rubbish bins. And then there was some sightings popping up in North Carolina about clowns around the school in North Carolina.
Anyway, in around October, I started to notice the clowns. I saw them on social media and I was checking literally every single day if there was a sighting in my area, and I was scared shitless, to be honest.
Around September, the clowns started to post threats to schools, to many schools, and those schools were actually put in lockdown because some clowns were actually spotted around the school that they made threats to. Some clowns just made threats and didn't come to school, but some clowns actually did come to the school, and those schools had to be put on lockdown.
I got the news from someone on October 8th, 2016. They had told me, well, I saw it actually. I actually had a run-in with a clown type of character myself. Now, I know that these aren't real clowns. These are just people trying to scare people. But I don't know, the guy that I saw was a musician, but it definitely did scare me, and it was around the clown times as well. I was walking down and then this man suddenly popped out of the corner. He was alright. I mean, I got scared, you know, he had that stuff on. I had no idea about the clowns at these times. So he had makeup on and obviously, you know, the clown sort of stuff, but it was like a Joker face, but we'll just say it was like a clown because it looked like that sort of makeup. You know, the not like the red like the Joker, but the darker colours, like, you know, the white and the black for the clown, you know, that sort of thing. So then when I got to the bus stop, he saw me, he started dancing when he saw me as well. And I was scared of my own area after that. And I know he didn't have bad intentions, but I was just on edge for a while after that. And it wasn't really a clown sighting, it was just something, a clown type of character I saw around those times. And then one of the people that told me, they told me, clowns are popping up around England, UK, everywhere. And this is when I started to say, oh my god, this is real, this is happening. I had a thought to myself, like, it always never ever did the rumours, ever. They never, ever came out into the lights. They always stayed in the dark, hidden through the dark corners of social media. More and more sightings popped up every day, but I never ever saw a clown myself. But I knew they were there. I knew they were there. I knew they were everywhere. Just waiting to lurk. Just waiting to pop out. Destroying the career of clowns to actually have good intentions.
When they want to take a picture, we say, is that to scare someone? Because if it is, we're not into that. We're into making people happy.
On October 15th, it was a dark night. I just got done eating dinner. Little did I know, something was lurking about in my car park. I heard a stone being thrown at the window. I got up, I looked down and something was going into the bushes, and just as it was going into the bushes, I saw a makeup that looked like a clown.
This happened.
And I heard a laugh that sounded like a clown. This scared the living shit out of me.
I shut the balcony, locked the door, and I said, it's happened. I just said to myself, it's happened to me. I knew it was going to happen. Well, I didn't know it was going to happen. Later that night, I was searching, going frantic. I was in a hysteria, man. I was in a crazy hysteria. Searching online, what to do if I see a clown, how can I react? I heard another stone being thrown at my window, and this time, I was totally shitting myself. I didn't know what was going to happen next. Should I just go to bed, or should I call the police? The police, is this wasting police time? I didn't know. And I heard another stone being thrown at my window. And eventually, it stopped. All night, nothing came out of that window. Nothing, no sound, no stone, no nothing. I didn't know what happened. The next week, October 22nd, I was so scared for that whole week, looking behind my corner, looking behind my back each time.
In the early hours of Halloween, around 2 o'clock in the morning, I couldn't sleep because of Halloween. Even though I knew I wasn't going trick-or-treating because of the clown, I still knew that I was excited for Halloween because it was one of my favourite holidays, one of my favourite celebrations. Until I got up, I was hungry. I couldn't sleep, so I was thought, why don't I just eat something? I'm hungry anyway. Then when I got to the kitchen, I saw a clown standing there. The same clown with the same costume, with a large knife. He literally started to walk towards me and I smashed a guitar on his head in self-defense. I put the guitar back and the next thing I knew, he was gone. And he had texted me on my phone, actually, saying, meet me in the park at 7 o'clock tomorrow and have a great Halloween.
I got my BB gun ready. I got my skateboard and I went outside and I rode into the park because I knew he would be there, like he told me in a text message. When I got there, I was looking around for him and then I spotted him. He didn't have this costume on. He didn't have his costume on. But I knew it was him. I knew it. I took out my gun and I shot him. Right in front of me. No reason whatsoever. And from that day on, I just don't know what happened. I ran out of there. And I have no idea what happened.